There's a question that people ask. They say, what's the greatest question to ask? What's the one that matters the most? And whether it's a question of religion or whatever, a lot of times what people arrive at is the question of whether or not they believe in something called God. This is a ridiculous question. It's a question for children. If you don't understand how to identify God in the natural environment and the universe around you, then you don't have a leg to stand on when it comes to saying whether or not you believe in it. That doesn't matter. A belief in God is not important. The most important question, the one that everyone has to ask, the one that everyone has to ask because the reality behind it is eventually going to sneak up on all of us, is not whether or not we believe in God. It's whether or not we believe in anything beyond death. Death is the ultimate reality that reaches all of us. Death is the thing that we are all staring in the face. Death is the thing that we all need to be most concerned about, not God. God really doesn't enter the equation at all. Death is some serious business, but you know, the reason that you people have issues is because you have improper views of the way that death relates to life. Many people thinking of death as the opposite of life. Death is the end of life. Life is not attached to birth any more than life is attached to death. Death is attached to birth. Birth and death are opposites. Those are equals. Life is a wheel around the outside of those things that encompasses both of them. None of you have been able to live without killing other things and eating them first. Other things have to die to keep you alive. When you die, there won't be any death there. There will be all kinds of life. New life. Now the question is, spiritually, consciously, intellectually, as a being manifesting yourself energetically, the way things really are, not in material sense, but in the sense of who you are. Who are you really? Are you really just your body? Does your imagination, your memories, your thoughts, your feelings, your emotions, all of the things that you've experienced and felt and said and done that don't add up to physical being? Did none of that happen? Is none of that important? This is the question. This is the ultimate question. It's not a question of whether or not God exists. That is not a religious question. That is not a question that matters. It is a false question put up by false people who don't understand really what's going on, which is life, birth, death, birth, death, birth, death. It's a circle, just like everything else. Now, you can throw yourself off the track. There are ways to do that. We will discuss those at another time. But today, this is only about the good news. At the introduction to the Bortal Thortal, which is the Tibetan Book of the Dead, Carl Gustav Jung, who is the father of leftist spiritualist psychology and New Age nut jobs in an academic scholastic American society, all Western society. He wrote in the introduction to that book that the problem with Western society was that we did not believe in reincarnation. We will never fix our problems until we believe that there is something after death to play for. Otherwise, it's just get. Get it while the getting's good. You have one life, one time, that's it. And fuck the world and fuck the future. That's a humanist positive. That's the human positive modernist viewpoint on life and death. Get it now, because you'll never get it again. Carl Gustav Jung says that's the main problem. We need to believe in reincarnation. We have this guy, the Dalai Lama. He's been alive 14 times in a consecutive cycle. They proved that through supposedly this scientific test, etc. The entire Buddhist worldview coming out of Tibet is geared around the understanding of reincarnation. But let's go beyond Buddhism, and let's go beyond Tibet. You look at Chinese folk religion. Why do they have shrines to their ancestors in their houses? Reincarnation used to be a science. It used to be something that worked. It used to be something that people understood. It used to be something that could make people literally immortal. Now you look for that through chemicals. You look through that through stem cells. You want to do that by uploading your being, your consciousness, onto a computer and saving it for a download to be inserted into a new synthetic, artificially constituted body. Good luck with that. I've been immortal for the last 100,000 years or more. I was here when this whole thing started. You could be too. You already have. The question of whether or not it works isn't a question of others. It's you.